everyone, welcome back. This is Sabrina. I am glad that you're here. I am gonna be doing another 3-in-1 with a Mandy Ford printable kit called Aptured. And this one is a beautiful, bright, vibrant kit, and I just love it. I've already done one project with this in my journal. I'll leave a link up in the eye, but this is the project. I did a journal spread and I love it. It's turned out so good. So let me show you what the kit looks like. I printed this on a different type of paper, just very thin paper to use. This is a beautiful rainbow patterned paper with all the colors of the kit. This is a cutout sheet with some frames, a journal, a few words, and some faux washi strips. This one is another pattern paper, a bunch of binder clips. Beautiful binder clips. And then this one is another pattern paper, but you could also totally fussy cut those out as well. And then another pattern paper with some flowers. And then the cameras. I just love the cameras. So awesome. And then this one I already kind of used, and it's just a beautiful neutral pattern paper. There's also one other cutout sheet, and I decided to cut it out already. So let me show you a few of the things that are in here. So of course some flowers, and then a few cameras. I just love these. And then lots of words, don't forget, happy, the best, explore, loved, memories, noted, lots of beautiful florals, and then a camera. This camera I have to reprint because, as you can tell, it got something on it, so I'm gonna reprint that. But I have all of those cut out and ready to use for my projects. Now let me show you the projects using this kit. When I saw the purples and the blues and kind of the neutral brown, I thought about doing the hike page with my friend. And I will pull out all those blues and purples, and it'll be really fun to document our hike together. So I'm gonna do that page. And then also I have a outside the page protector pocket page to do. So this is 6.75 by 8.25. And it is a collage for my May every day. And I just print this on the paper that I use for stamping. I just print it on there, turn down the opacity to like 50%. And then that way I don't have to worry about aligning anything because I'm not the best at that. But I turn down the opacity and then I can just add in the photos I have, which is right here. And then I also use my Cameo to cut out a few of the pieces. These are just solid blocks that I pulled the colors from the kit. And then I have three pieces that I shrunk down from the pattern paper. Okay, so those are the two projects that I'm gonna put together in this video, and I hope you guys enjoy. I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to voiceover. All right, so for this project, I'm gonna start by cutting out these two large flowers and then the word favorite. Because like I said in the intro, for this page, I'm gonna mainly stick with just pulling out the purples and the pinks and the neutral colors. So I'm gonna have several of the words, well, a few of the words that match the colors that I'm pulling, and then I'll use the two large flowers as kind of an anchor point for my visual triangle. And then this part here, I thought it would be fun to include because I have no idea what I was thinking. I know that I put down the photos a while ago when I was printing out the rest of the photos for my notebook, but I decided, you know what, it might be smart to just, because I couldn't get the photo of me off down in the bottom right, I couldn't get it off. And so I decided to just measure what I needed, and that way I could tuck it underneath the photo. And I marked it with the pencil, as you saw just a few seconds ago, and then I kind of stepped away from it. And then I came back to it. And now I'm gonna cut out the piece that I outlined, and I wound up cutting it way too short. Like, it wasn't even able to tuck under the photo, and there was a gap after the photo and the strip. It was just a mess. And so what I did is I glued down what I had You can barely tell that there's a very small gap between the photo and the strip. And I just took the piece that had a gap at the right of the photo and I just cut that off and then put it back together. So in the end, you probably can't tell, but I felt like I was making a giant mess. And so when I did the left side, I tried the measurements again. That did not work. So I just ripped up the photo, put down the strip, moved on. And now I am moving on to adding down the words and also adding down the die cuts that I want to use, which is the flower, the best, and a small little flower. And then the bigger flower is the purple one on the left-hand side. And then I decided to add in some confetti. I had several reasons for going with a flat kind of embellishment, and that's mainly because my notebook was getting very, very large, but also because I just wanted to try something different, and I've tried confetti on a few other pages. And so what I do is I take this super old punch that I have and I just punch out the paper and I make a huge pile of confetti pieces and then painstakingly use my glue pen and add on little pieces. And so I make a scattering of the confetti and I really, really like it. I don't use nearly as many pieces as I punch. I mean, most of them get recycled, but I just have that way I have a good variety of different shapes and different colors when I punch out the papers. So I do a scattering on the left bottom and then the top right, and then I'm also going to do a small one by the word favorite and then a fourth one by the photo on the bottom left. So I have my visual triangle and it just helps your eye to move around the page, and also it doesn't add any more bulk to my notebook. So there you go, a little close up of the project and the confetti, and then I'll move on to the next spread. In this next spread, I am gonna add everything except the kitchen sink, or everything in the kitchen sink. I don't know how the saying goes, but that's what I'm gonna do. I add so many pattern papers and so many different little phrases. I just had a lot of fun putting together this collage grid type page for my May Every Day. And I am just adhering down the photos. I do switch the photo of a drawing that I did with my daughter and my husband. I switch those because when I printed it out, something must have gotten moved, because if you had noticed earlier, I had the photo of my husband, I have two of them, and I put them all in the same column, and that was not going to work. So I put one over on the right-hand side of the paper. I have them all adhered down, and now I am going to kind of figure out how I want to embellish this spread. I start out by cutting out some binder clips, and I also cut out some cameras, but then I decide to go with a large camera, and I also have a May acrylic, which I tend to use those thin acrylics from Colorcast Designs to kind of mark each month, so I will be using that, and then a few other wood veneer pieces that I find along the way. And I'll fussy cut out these binder clips because I know that I am going to use a few of them and also a few of the flowers as well. And then I'm going to get out my butterfly punch and punch out a few of the butterfly shapes with the rainbow pattern paper. I told you I use everything in this project. I just love it. It's full of colors and it's full of different types of embellishments. I also fussy cut out that recorded as a kind of another title piece, and I decided for May that I would put it on that neutral cream brown paper instead of the blue. It doesn't fade away. The May isn't gonna fade away, but it's not gonna get lost. So it'll still stand out even if it's a little muted, and that's okay with me. I add in the words happy and loved, and I'm also going to pull out some wood veneer, like I said, and I'll choose all about me, reading this, and playtime. Playtime is down at the bottom where my son was literally squashing me on the floor. I think I was tired, and then he just decided to join me on the floor, so I was reminded again of him being 5 years old. And I also have a mad face too, which is mom life, right? And I am just adding in all these little pieces and pop dotting the happy and also the recorded as well. And then adding in the binder clips down at the bottom next to the recorded. And then I decided at the last minute to add in a little pop of yellow by tearing one of the washi strips and adding it to the far left of the recorded. I wish I had added in more yellow because it kind of would have gone with the Morgan Harper Nicholas quote, but that's okay. I needed to stop fussing with this and just keep moving forward. So adding in all the little clusters and the final little details, and then I can wrap up this spread and both of these little projects. So I hope you guys enjoyed seeing how I used this printable kit from Mandy Ford and enjoyed seeing all my projects come to life. I would love a thumbs up or a subscribe if you are new to my channel. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day. Bye.